Systems of records are continuously creating a ton of data on what is happening across your process. To me and you, it's just a raw format. It's not very useful to the human eye. That's where Power Automate process mining comes in. You can connect to this data directly from your system of record, either SAP, Dynamics, wherever it be, or you can connect directly to your Azure data lake, as I am doing here. I'm able to define the container where this data resides and able to connect directly to it. Copilot is able to help me identify from that raw table what process it is describing. In this case, it finds that this is a procure-to-pay process. Once I confirm that's the process I'm interested in analyzing, it takes me to a mapping experience where it auto-maps to my required data schema. I'm now ready to analyze this process. As you can see here, I get to a pretty complicated process map on my procure-to-pay process. I can use the app to dig deeper, or I can have Copilot guide me as it's doing here in identifying what are my top insights and what are my potential bottlenecks. I ask Copilot to help me identify that top bottleneck, and it gives me two suggestions for automation. The first suggestion is to create a flow to alert on non-compliant POs. Copilot passes this suggestion to the NL2 Flow Copilot in Power Automate. This copilot takes the process context and helps you create a flow to address your bottleneck. You can work with the copilot to read your data from a specific state or to make additions, changes, or expansions from that original suggestion until you get to the flow you are interested in. We go back to Power Automate Process Mining to select the second suggestion, which is the creation of a new Power App view to track non-compliant POs in my P2P process. Copilot in Process Mining has shared the context with the Power App Copilot to edit a new view. We can work iteratively with Copilot to get to a final screen of PO management. Now, to monitor my P2P process, I can create a custom dashboard to track contextual metrics like POs without PR percents and changes over time. I can view this report in Process Mining or export it to Power BI, where I have access to create more custom visuals, as well as use Power BI's powerful AI features that allow me to ask my data questions, like I am doing here, around rework activities.